New research by flat shirt site SpareRoom reveals that over 16% of young adults aged 18 to 24 were forced to borrow money due to COVID-19, did so to pay for private mental health care. I spoke with Matt Hutchinson, director of SpareRoom, to find out more.
We asked people between the age of 18 and 40 what the financial situation was as a result of COVID, because we know it's affected people really badly and people have lost their jobs. And we found that one in four of people aged 18 to 40 has borrowed money as a direct result of COVID. And for two-thirds of them, they say it's the first time they've ever borrowed money. And the average amount is between £1,500 and £2,000, but some people are borrowing up to £30,000 at the moment.
That's impressive. And of course, the furlough scheme didn't actually include the Generation Z. For most of them, they probably didn't have a permanent job or anything financially viable before the pandemic. And what do you think is going to happen?
I mean, I think we're in an interesting place anyway, because even pre-pandemic, such a huge chunk of, you know, people under 30 particularly are still living with parents because it's so hard to afford to get onto either the housing ladder or just to afford to rent. And a lot of those people have gone home and will be living with parents now. So it's going to be a real struggle for people to get past this hurdle. You know, a lot of people have told us that it's not just a case of having taken some debt on. It's also about postponing plans they had, whether that's to move or to get married or to have a family. Or, you know, it's actually going to set people back, not just this one year, but several years, I think.
Where are they borrowing the money from?
The majority, almost half of them, are actually borrowing it from their parents. You know, the Bank of Mum and Dad, as it's come to be known, is helping out. But also we're finding that some mums and dads are opening the hotel of Mum and Dad and taking their kids back in at the moment, because if they've lost a job and have no way of paying the rent, that's maybe an easier way to help in some ways.
That's a tragedy within the tragedy. So what do you think the financial impact of COVID-19 had on the mental health of Generation Z, but not just them?
So the people who told us they borrowed money, 15% of them said they'd actually borrowed money to pay for mental health services. Because, you know, as anybody who's been through the system or knows somebody who has knows, it can take a long time to get an appointment if you need mental health services in the UK at the moment. Services are incredibly stretched. And I think this year particularly has had a tough impact on the younger generations. It's made us very disconnected. Connection is one of the things that is very, very important for mental health.
So where do you reckon that the lifestyle sacrifice and cutbacks that they had to make went mainly?
I mean, people have struggled just to pay for essential things like bills and food and rent, but also people are cutting back on lifestyle things like eating out and takeaways, buying clothes and travel. But it's a combination, I think, of, you know, nearly half the people we surveyed said they'd had trouble just paying for their food and their bills.
That's incredible. How long do you think it's going to take them to pay off their debt and back the way they used to be in 2019?
I mean, people have told us they don't expect their spending habits to get back to normal anytime this year. And I think a lot of people, you know, one in 10 said that it's going to take at least 4 years to repay their debt. And some don't think they ever will.
Is there anything else you would like to add?
No, I mean, I think it's, you know, it is a tragedy for the younger generations, and it's one of the sad facts about COVID is that it's forced us all to be separate from each other. And being, you know, coming from the perspective of a company, we deal with people sharing their lives, people who flat share, and that's, we know the social benefits of being around other people. And it's been, there's a lot being said about how isolated old people can be with the pandemic, and that's very true, and that is incredibly serious. But I think we underestimate how isolated some young people have become, and I think it may well take people a while to get past that. And I think it's a real shame for the younger generations to have that isolation and to have to deal with that at this stage.